Hey all, Blake here with another video, and today I want to cover off a topic that often, you know, brings a lot of people down and a lot of people get really pent up about it, but I just thought it would be an interesting one today to have a chat about whether or not you should get an Oscar fish. Let's jump straight into the video. Okay, so first of all, obviously, Oscar fish are very, very popular within the hobby. They're probably, I would say, the most popular on the larger side of fish, and that's because often there's a lot of misleading information and education around these fish. I'm not really gonna get into, oh, you have to do this and you should do this. What I am gonna get into is, are you willing to do this? Are you willing to do that? And that's how we're gonna answer today the question that you might be asking yourself, which is, should I get an Oscar fish? Now recently, I did go out and I got 4 Oscars, which I probably wouldn't recommend to most people, but I have kept them before for a long period of time. Actually, when I first kicked off the channel, I had quite a large one. I'm not sure whether I have footage. If I did, I'll overlay it now, but I absolutely loved this Oscar fish. He was my wet pet, my big Labrador puppy. And I had lids on the aquarium. He sadly broke through the lids one day and ended up on the floor. So the first one would be, do you have strong lids on your aquarium? Recently, I've changed from glass lids for that reason to core flute lids or greenhouse panel lids. This stuff right here. So it's just, you know, clear plastic that you can see through. It's got 2 walls, and I have these lids on the tank that the Oscars are going into with the Saratoga, because if you know anything about Saratogas or Arowanas, they bang into the lids all the time when they're trying to jump out. So first thing I would recommend, if you're gonna get an Oscar fish, replace your lids with this stuff and fit them tightly, because Oscars do jump. A lot of people might not realize that. Second thing I wanna talk about is, are you actually willing to get a bigger tank? For one Oscar, a minimum size tank is a 75-gallon aquarium, approximately 300 liters. What we're gonna look for is 120 centimeters or 4 foot by 18 inches or 45 centimeters by 18 inches or 45 centimeters. This is a pretty big aquarium, and a lot of people aren't willing to find the space in their fish room or house for a tank this size. And you might think that you could squeeze them into a slightly narrower aquarium, but trust me, they will get big and it won't take too long either. Oscars are one of those fish that they don't really give you the time to decide whether you want to get a bigger tank. They grow massively in the first 12 months, so it won't take long at all and you'll have a fish that's way too big. So do keep that in mind. I know that it's kind of harped on about and it can get a bit like a nagging sort of thing at a certain point, but realistically, they get big fast and you're going to enjoy them a lot more in that bigger space. You'll get to see them swim around, you'll get to interact with them and sort of train them in a way. Third thing that you should consider if you want Oscars are, do you want plants or not? If you do have Oscars, they can be a bit mischievous. They have their own little personalities and they will just shred plants for the fun of it. So you might be limited to things like Anubias, Java fern, or things that are going to grow outside of your aquarium like Pothos. So just keep that in mind. You're not going to have a nice delicately planted aquarium with, you know, like fine-leaved limnophilas or Rotila wallichii or something like that. You're not going to be able to get these really sort of delicate plants within your aquarium with Oscars. They are essentially like a Labrador, I've said it before, but they're a big bustly thing that doesn't realize the size that they are, and they will just burst through everything. So you are going to be limited to what you can decorate within your aquarium, but that's just something to keep in mind. We're not all plant people, and I understand that as well. Similarly, you want to be mindful of things like driftwood, because they do have these big bulging eyes and they can actually damage them on driftwood. If you have you know, some gold vine or other driftwood which has a lot of branching sections, you will find that they've got this massive paddle tail and they can just powerfully go through the water, and sometimes it leads them directly into poking their eye out with a stick. So none of us want that, so yeah, just keep that in mind when decorating your aquarium. You will be a little bit limited. Another thing to consider is, can you afford it? They are big fish, they eat a lot of food, and they'll keep eating it as long as you serve it up. So are you willing to spend a fair bit of money to actually feed these fish? And I wouldn't recommend just cheaping out on the food. You know, you don't get the cheapest dog food out there, so I wouldn't recommend getting the cheapest fish food either. You'll see a lot better coloration and condition in your fish if you do get a more high quality food. So keep in mind the expense of actually keeping them, and that includes things like the filtration, the lighting, and the water, because we're gonna have to change a lot of water. On that topic, Oscars, they have, they actually grind the food in the back of their throats, and they create a lot of mess as it comes out of the gills. So we are gonna have to have some beefy filtration. We're gonna have to do a lot of water changes because they're a messy, messy fish. So keep in mind that they're gonna be a lot more work than that bedder you've had in your small tank on your bedside table or something like that, or your kitchen table. They're gonna require hands-on maintenance. At least, I'd say at least 50% water change once per week. So keep that in mind. And because we are limited with plants, we really have to stick to that weekly schedule, or else we're gonna run into a few problems, so. Another thing to consider is that if good water conditions aren't maintained, Oscars are prone to a disease called hole in the head. Also, you might have heard it called hexamita. Basically, a parasite infects the intestines, and the appearance is as if there's holes developing in the head of the Oscar. This isn't a big concern so long as you maintain good water quality and proper nutrition, but it's just something to be aware of, that they are prone to this disease if the conditions aren't met. Well, I don't want this video to be all doom and gloom, so let's talk about the positives. One of them is that they are massive and they'll be a great feature. All your friends coming around will be amazed that this beautiful big fish is in such good condition and is so friendly. They're one of the most highly personable fish in the hobby that I've found, or that I've kept to date, and they'll be straight up the front corner, usually the corner that you feed them from, begging you to basically feed them, but we'll pretend like they're saying hello and greeting us at the door. They're not going to be shy or scared away at all, and it's really fantastic. Also, for a big American cichlid, usually they have a reputation as this sort of angry, aggressive, moody individual. Oscars, I don't find it that way at all. No, I don't really mind. So long as the other fish keep out of their way, you know, they're just happy doing their thing, eating their food, and just swimming around being a happy boy. So you'll get a lot of joy out of Oscars. And it's one of the reasons that after keeping Oscars, going through Jags, Jack Dempsey's, Flowerhorns, and other big fish, I'm circling back because I absolutely love them, and I haven't found a fish that has brought me as much joy in the sense of these bigger fish than the Oscar has. So I can't wait to grow these guys out. Another great positive is that they look really nice, and you can get lots of different types these days. You can have lemon Oscars, which have generally a paler body but are not albino in that they don't have the red eyes. You can of course get albinos, you can get tiger Oscars, you can get red Oscars, which have more of that orange patterning on the side. There's heaps of different types, and they're all fantastic in their own right. So you can sort of hunt around and get some specialty Oscars which are, you know, perhaps more to your liking than the tiger Oscars that I definitely favor. They're my favorite type of Oscar. So there are some different types you can choose from as well, which is pretty good. Really importantly, there are some downsides, but they have some massive upsides, and that is that they're easy to feed and they're easy to breed. So they're a big American cichlid. They'll pair up naturally, guard their own eggs, and raise up the wigglers to fry. You might have to separate them once they're at the free swimming stage, but for the most part, they'll be pretty good parents, but they might get a bit territorial at that stage as well. So you will have to keep that in mind. That's not unusual with any cichlid really, but it's a positive, I think, for Oscars, that what's cooler than duplicating your big friendly fish that you love so much. So they are certainly breedable within the hobby environment. So I think that's always a big positive as well. Another great positive is they are a lot more compatible with tank mates than other fish. I covered it off a little bit before that. They're kind of friendly, and as long as things leave them alone, they're pretty good. So I've found Oscars do fine with things like silver dollars, common plecos, my Saratoga that I keep them with. They'll also do well with Geophagus and lots of other cichlids as well. Generally, they'll be the subject of being beaten up. So they can actually be really handy in a nice mean, aggressive tank. If you get one to be the biggest fish, then they can be a quite peaceful boss. There's nothing worse than having a mean dictator as the boss of the tank that's just gonna go and ravage everything. Sometimes it's a really great idea to have a passive big fella as kind of the boss to say, like, you two leave each other alone over there. We're all just gonna live in harmony around here. So it can be a real asset to have in one of those big aggressive tanks as well. So keep that in mind. If this is your first time coming across Oscar fish and you're interested in what actual care requirements and tank conditions they require, well, I'll run through them really quick now just in case. So we have spoken about minimum tank size 75 gallons or around about a 4 foot aquarium on the wider side. Temperature wise, you want to keep them between 75 and 80 degrees Fahrenheit or 23 to 27 degrees Celsius. They're pretty hardy and they'll accept a pH range between 6 and 8, but they do come from more neutral waters in the wild. They are a carnivore and in the wild they generally eat on insects and small invertebrates. So I find floating foods to be best and definitely high protein foods to really get the optimal conditioning into your Oscars. So feed high quality floating, high protein food and you should be good. They will readily take to pre-prepared foods like pellets. They won't really do much with flakes because there's no flakes really big enough. They also really love bloodworms and once they get big, they'll just take the whole cube at once. So I find that to be a really favorite food amongst the Oscar fish. And Oscars are what's called monomorphic, I believe, which means that the females and males look identical. The only way to tell the difference is by venting, which basically means taking them out of the aquarium, turning them upside down, and having a look at the reproductive organs of the fish. It's a bit more of an in-depth topic, and it's more of a specialist thing, so you can wait for them to just pair off naturally once they get to a suitable size. I'd keep them in groups of either one or three or more, unless you have a proven pair, which then of course you can keep them as a pair. But if you keep two together that aren't a bonded pair, then they'll probably just attack each other and the larger one will win. For that reason, I like to have one as a solitary fish or three or more so that they can disperse the aggression between themselves. As well as that, upon time to do water changes, don't be concerned if the Oscars are just hiding in the corner, looking sad, turning off all their colors, and just sulking around. They do have a personality, as I have mentioned, and they get really sooky when you change the water. So just remind yourself that you're doing it for their benefit, and they'll be fine the next day or two, so don't worry about it too much. So there you go, guys. I'd suggest that if you're willing to put in the work and you're willing to get the infrastructure, then definitely get an Oscar fish. They're gonna be one of the most intelligent, personable fish. They come in a brilliant coloration and they're just a genuine wet pet. So hopefully you like this video. Hopefully it's provided you with a little bit of food for thought and helped guide your decision-making around picking up that cute little Oscar fish for your 10 gallon or not. If you like this video, it really helps me out to smash like, hit subscribe and all that fun stuff. Other than that, I'll catch you on the next one. Thanks for watching.